Hi, this is Tim from Esri. In this video, we'll follow the Explore Your Data tutorial in ArcGIS Pro. The tutorial focuses on different ways to view and analyze attribute data, the descriptive information associated with features in a map layer. You can follow the step-by-step instructions for this tutorial in the ArcGIS Pro documentation. Okay, let's get started. I've started ArcGIS Pro and I'm signed in. I'll open a project from ArcGIS Online. Click Open Another Project. Make sure ArcGIS Online is selected. Type Explore Your Data Tutorial and press Enter. I get a couple of results. Look for the symbol that means the dataset is authoritative and click OK. When the project opens, we see a map of New Zealand. One way to get information about a place is to click on the map. The Map tab is active on the ribbon and the Explore tool is selected. When I click on the Canterbury region, the pop-up pane opens and shows me its attributes. It's mostly about livestock. Notice that one of the attributes is a hyperlink. We'll come back to that later. If I click another region, like Waikato, I see its pop-up. All the features in the regions layer have the same attributes, or categories of information. What's different are the individual values. This information is stored in a table called the Layer Attribute Table. I can right-click the regions layer and open the table. The map and the table are connected. When I click a row in the table, the corresponding map feature is selected. When I clear the selected record, the map feature is deselected as well. It also works the other way. If I use the Select tool on the ribbon to select a map feature, or a few features, the matching records are selected in the table. You can show only the selected records or all the records. To find out which region has the most sheep, I can sort the table on that field. It's Manawatu Wanganui. Sorry, I'm not sure about the pronunciation. To see the region on the map, I select the record. Before I do more data exploration, I want to simplify the table display. Attribute tables sometimes have more information than you need for your purposes, or maybe the field names aren't very clear, and so on. You can work with the table properties in the Field Designer. I'll right-click the layer, point to Data Design, and click Fields. It opens another view, which looks like a table. And it is a table of table properties. By checking boxes in the Visible column, I can choose which fields to show. In this case, just a few. I can also alias the field names to use a more descriptive name or one that looks better. To format numeric values, double-click in the Number Format cell and click on the button that appears. These changes don't affect the data itself, just the table display. I'm going to change some of the other fields in the same way, but not show it in the video. Now we need to save the design changes and close the fields view. If you don't see your changes immediately, you can refresh the table. Here's the result. Just the fields we're interested in, formatted in a more readable way. I can open a pop-up from the table, and we see that it reflects the new formatting. I'll save the project here. Let's get back to data exploration. Probably the most common way to interrogate your data is with attribute queries. On the Map tab, click Select by Attributes. We're working with the Regions layer by default, because it's selected in the Contents pane. Suppose we want to know which New Zealand regions have more than a million sheep. We can construct a query that looks like this. Basically, it says, look in the Sheep 2014 field and select records with a value greater than or equal to 1 million. By the way, the only fields we can choose from are the ones we made visible in the Field Designer, and you'll find that those settings are also honored elsewhere in the project. When I apply the query, the records are selected in the table and the features are selected on the map. Eight regions meet the condition. We can make the query more complex. Suppose I want to know which regions have a million sheep and a lot of beef cattle, let's say half a million. I can add another clause to the query. The two clauses are connected by the AND operator, so both conditions have to be met. Click OK. Only one region meets this more restrictive condition. That's Manawatu Wanganui. Another way to get information about attributes is through summary statistics, which are things like totals, averages, median values, and so on. For instance, suppose I want to know whether there are more sheep on the North Island or the South Island. I've already prepared a summary statistics table for the North Island. There are about 14 million sheep there. Now I'll make the same table for the South Island. By the way, these are standalone tables, not layer attribute tables. That means they're not linked to features on the map. First, I need to select the appropriate map features or table records. I'll use the polygon select tool and draw a shape that includes all the regions on the South Island. Double-click to finish the polygon. It doesn't have to enclose the features, just touch them. There should be 7 selected features, and there are. Now I click the Analysis tab on the ribbon. In the Analysis gallery, I click on Summary Statistics, which opens the tool in the Geoprocessing pane. For the input table, I pick Regions. Only the 7 selected records will be analyzed. I give the output table a name, then pick the fields I want statistics on and add them. The default statistic is sum, which is what we want, but I could click the drop-down arrow and choose from a bunch of others. Let's run the tool. The output is a new standalone table. The tool gave a warning message because one of the summarized fields has a blank cell value, but that's not a problem for us. The table shows that the South Island has about 1 million more sheep than the North Island. I'll close the geoprocessing pane, come back to the map tab, and clear the selected features. When we sorted the table earlier, we saw which regions had the most sheep. It would be more visually effective to see that information in a chart. I'll right-click the regions layer, point to charts, and click bar chart. That opens the chart properties pane and a blank chart view. For the category to chart, I'll pick the region name and pick sheep 2014 as the numeric field. Click apply and sort on the y-axis. On the general tab, I'll change the chart title. When I press enter, the chart updates. I'll do the same for the axis titles. A couple of the region names are cut off. On the axes tab, I can increase the default character limit. I'll dock the chart in a different place to make it bigger. You can hover over a bar to get its exact value. You can also label the bars with their values, but I forgot to do that. If I select a bar or a few bars, the corresponding map features are selected. And of course, the corresponding table records are also selected. I'll close the table view and deselect the bars on the chart by clicking on some white space over here, and close the chart properties pane. The chart is stored right here with the map layer. You can right-click and open it from this location whenever you want. And I'll close the chart now. The last thing I'll do is configure the pop-ups to show some special information. Recall that one of the attributes was a hyperlink. These hyperlinks go to images of New Zealand stored in ArcGIS Online. I'll right-click the regions layer and click Configure Pop-ups. In the Configure Pop-ups pane, I'll click the Image button. This adds an image element to the pop-up. Now I click to edit it. I won't bother with image titles or captions, so I'll make these fields blank. I'll set the source URL field to image URL. That's the name of the field in the attribute table with the hyperlinks. Click the back button on the pane. On the ribbon, make sure the Explore tool is selected, and we can start clicking features on the map. The pop-up pane shows a different image for each feature. In this video, we looked at the relationship between map features and table records. We used the field designer to format a table. We composed attribute queries, made a table of summary statistics, created a bar chart, and configured pop-ups. You can learn a lot more in the ArcGIS Pro documentation.